Kathy Karthi. Welcome to our geological zone. So today we are going to learn about classification of sedimentary rocks. But before moving on to classification, let us revise what are sedimentary rocks. So the rocks formed by WEDCC method are known as sedimentary rocks. Now you might be wondering, what is WEDCC? So let me explain you word to word. First, W stands for weathering. Weathering is breakdown of pre-existing rock in the form of sediments. E stands for erosion. Erosion is transportation of these sediments from one location to another. D is deposition. As the name says, deposition of these eroded sediments. The first C here stands for compaction. Compaction means coming together of these deposited sediments to hold a particular shape. Then the later on C stands for cementation. Cementation means mixing up of matrix and sediments to get a particular shape so that a rock is formed. Now, this was all about sedimentary rocks. Let us move on to classification of sedimentary rocks. On the basis of origin, sedimentary rocks are divided into two types. First is the clastic sedimentary rock and second is the non-clastic sedimentary rocks. Clastic sedimentary rocks are formed due to mechanical accumulation of sediments. The particles included in clastic sedimentary rocks, their size ranges from large boulders to small fine clay particles. These are formed due to chemical and biological processes. And the size of the sediments which are included in non-clastic rocks is very fine grain. So, clastic sedimentary rocks are further divided into three subcategories on the basis of their size of sediments according to the Wentworth-Pudden scale. So first one is the rudaceous, second is the arenaceous, and third one is the argillaceous. We will deal about these sedimentary rocks individually. So now we will learn about rudaceous sedimentary rocks. These types of rocks are also known as lutite rocks. They are formed due to mechanical accumulation of large fragments of sediments, which include gravels, pebbles, cobbles, and sometimes also boulders. So now we mentioned large fragments. Henceforth, the grain size of these sedimentary rocks is more than 2 mm in diameter. The grain falling in these categories of rudaceous rock, they have traveled less distance. Some examples of these rudaceous sedimentary rocks are conglomerate and breccia. Wherein conglomerate have rounded grains and breccia have angular grains. Here is a picture of conglomerate and breccia. So second type of sedimentary rocks is the arenaceous rocks. These are composed of small sand and silt particles. They are also known as prismatic rocks. Now we mentioned here sand and silt particle. Hence we can determine that the size of the sediments might be between 1 to 2 mm in diameter. The grain falling in this category of clastic sedimentary rocks traveled intermediate distance. Some example of arenaceous rocks are sandstone and grit. Sandstone and grit. Where sandstone have rounded grains and grit have angular grains. Angular grains. So here is a picture of sandstone and grit. The last type of clastic sedimentary rock is argillaceous rock. These rocks are formed by very fine grain sediments. They are also known as pelletic rocks. Now here we mentioned very fine grain, which means the grain size will be less than 1 mm in diameter. Grain size less than 1 mm in diameter. Grain falling in argillaceous category of rock travel much larger distance. So some examples of these are mudstone and shale. They actually can't determine the grains is either rounded or angular because they are very fine grain and nearly they are not visible to our naked eyes. These types of rocks are found near deltaic region. So here is a picture of mudstone and shale.
Now we learned about clastic sedimentary rocks and its classification. Now let us move on to second type of classification, which is of non-clastic sedimentary rocks. So non-clastic sedimentary rocks are the rocks which are formed by various chemical or organic processes. Hence, on the method of formation, these types of rocks are divided into two subcategories. First one is the chemically formed rocks. And second one is the organically formed rocks. These types of rocks are formed when mineral matter is precipitated in water, and these types of rocks contains mainly dead and decaying plant and animals. So now let us learn about chemically formed rocks. Chemically formed rocks are formed due to precipitation of mineral matter in solution, as mentioned earlier. So these are further divided into four subcategories on the basis of their chemical composition. First one is the carbonate rocks. Second is the siliceous rocks. Third is the ferrugineous rocks. And fourth one is the salt rock. So now let us start with the first type of chemically formed rocks, which is carbonate rocks. These rocks are formed due to chemical precipitation of calcium carbonate in water. Example of these rocks are limestone and chalk. Here is an image of both. Second type is the siliceous rocks. They are formed due to precipitation of silica in solution. Precipitation of silica in solution. Henceforth, we can determine that they are rich in SI content. So, example of these type of rocks are flint and chert. And there are many more. I have included only two. So, here is an image of flint and chert respectively. The third type of classification is of ferrugineous rocks. As the name says, ferro. Ferro here means Fe. We all know. So, we can say that these types of rock are rich in Fe and they are formed due to chemical precipitation of iron oxide in solution. Some examples of these are ironstone, etc. These types of rocks are formed due to evaporation of saline lakes. And example of these are gypsum and halite. Here it is shown. The second type of non-clastic sedimentary rock is organically formed rock. They are further divided into two subcategories. First one is the biochemical rock and second one is the carbonaceous rock. When the shell or any other hard particles of an organism living under water which get dead are deposited in large quantities on the ocean floors, which lead to the formation of biochemical rocks. Example of these rocks are shelly limestone, and fossiliferous chert. The second type of organically formed rock is the carbonaceous rock. These are organically formed and are rich in carbon. Example of these rock is coal and carbonaceous shale. So, this was all about classification of sedimentary rocks into clastic and non-clastic rocks. Thank you.